It's a Wow Sly here, just out in the garage, having an hour with the radios, sort of reconfiguring everything at the moment. As the old grow box is empty now, apart from I think the solar panel's still in there, and one speaker, and three-way 12-volt socket. The two radios that were in there have been exchanged for the handset. But this is just a quick little video about shit is the fan communications. I keep seeing a lot of people put on Facebook and so on, the groups, what shit is the fan comms do I use? Do I use CB? Amateur radio, PMR, and then they all start talking about licensing, obviously, for amateur radio. And all I can say is, as long as you've got a radio, that's better than no radio. Everyone, obviously, is different. Personal choice and preferences. I myself like the CB bands, the mid bands, 2 meters and 70 cm, as that's sort of the main ones I use. There are a lot of ever more frequencies on there, obviously, not just 2 meters and 70 cm, but that's what my handset does. It's predominantly used in this town, clubs. There's another 2 meter radio there, and again, sidebands. But the problem with all these different radios are different antennas, the mids and the normal FM CB on the 27-ish mark megahertz, so you can basically run a CB aerial for the mids. 2 meters, I can't remember the measurements now, don't quote me. I've made a few dipoles but I've forgotten. That's vertical like the CB, but then if you want to use sideband, that's horizontal, and then you've got rubber ducks for the handsets. And you've got different sizes. The last time I had that handset, I had a bigger rubber duck. That's the small one for it. For the 2 meter one, it came with a smaller rubber duck. And then I got the bigger one. This is like the one I had for the old CB. It's about 18 inches long. So it's a lot of hum-ha, what radio to get. Do you get the fist mic on a handset? Bigger battery? Do you run it off AAs? Do you get a mobile radio and run it off a car battery? But I recommend, for the UK, shit, it's the fan communications. You want to have at least two PMR radios, if not a pack of four. If you've got a bug out bag, chuck one in there. 20 or 30 quid. PMR radio might be worth, if you buy a two pack, carry them both, you might need a second one. Plus, if you're on a mountain and you break your leg, anyone that does any walking, you'll notice that a lot of walkers and ramblers do carry them, because generally if you do call out for help, there's a good chance someone's going to listen. But if you're somewhere where there's no mobile phone network, no one's going to hear you calling out on the phone with no signal. Find out what your most used frequency is in your area. People say about HF. That's great if you've got the right length for that frequency, bit of wire, somewhere to put it. If you want to be stealth, you don't want to be slinging up a big wire across between your houses or in your bug out location, then you need obviously power for it. Radios don't like getting wet and cold, so you've got to think, carry them about. And then there's licensing. A lot of people are worried about, if I buy an amateur radio for shit at the fan communications, I need a license. It is legal to use amateur radio, bearing in mind a lot of amateurs are probably going to shoot me for this. It's legal to use one without a license for emergency contact if no other communication is available. I think that's pretty much word for word. So if you're in a car accident on the motorway, and people are dead, and you have no phone signal, it is legal to use the amateur bands. But pretty much only that reason. And of course, if there is a, you know, world without law, anything shits the fan, I don't think the authorities are going to mind you not having a license. So, yeah, this was me personally. 2 meters, CB, with the added extra 70cm, which covers the PMR channels. And the mids. Mids aren't that popular, like the old AM. I've just got them in case you're talking to someone locally, you want to have a private conversation, you can flick over there because not everyone has it. Like PMR are great, it's 8 channels so anyone can listen. You can get radios with sub channels, but not everyone's got the sub channels. Just got that one scanning through at the moment, picking up stuff. So hopefully this video will give you a few ideas or enlighten a few people about licensing. It's £20, £27 something. For my foundation license, there's 3 licenses. The first one I've got allows me to run a maximum of 10 watts output. The next license is 50 watts, and I think the one after that you can use anything. I'm happy with 10 watts for the 2 meters. Gets me into about 70cm. Most of the repeaters around here are 70cm, but of course if there's a shit fan situation, the repeaters won't be working unless they've got backup generators and solar panels and batteries. So it'll be simplex channels only. And then there's Morse code. So yeah, if you are a prepper and you're thinking about bugging in or bugging out and you're unsure about radio communications or any sort of communications, you can learn Morse code, but remember, not everyone knows it. There was a tiny bit of Morse code in my exam. The next exam is a bit more Morse code, and the exam after that, there's a lot of Morse code, but still people don't know it. You sort of learn enough to get a pass. But not everyone, there's a lot of Morse coders out there, but I personally wouldn't want to spend hours learning it, as you know, it's not the most common used language. It's used widely. I'm not trying to deter people away from it, but you know, for shit is the fan communications, my personal preference is just 2 meters and CB and PMR. So many people with kids have got PMR radios I don't know about. There's Action Man, Barbie, most of them work on the 446 frequency. You can buy CBs on eBay, PMRs from Tesco's. These radios are widely available. Most of the ham stuff and CB runs off 12 volts. So I've got a couple of little batteries. I've got a big car battery as backup over there. One of the cells have gone, so it won't start a car, but it'll power radios for a long time. So you don't need to worry about, you know, supplying them. You can buy a decent power supply for the house. They can be expensive. I reconditioned a PC power supply and it kicks out 12 volts. 13.8 would be better, but it was free. That's it really. This thing here. All my radios, I've got rubber ducks, antennas on the house, and antennas for the car, plus wire antennas. So if I do go portable, I can sling a wire antenna up in the tree. I've got the Slim Jim, 2 meters and 70cm, obviously the PMR as well. I've got a wire antenna for the CB. And mag mounts are both, well, all the other radios. So I'm making this video mainly because people watch my videos on radios and on like certain groups on Facebook and of course on YouTube. There's general discussions a lot. Get asked a few questions. I'm no expert. Don't get me wrong, but I do recommend getting a radio for anything shits the fan. Right, we've got some cars pulling up now, so I'll cut this short. Thanks for watching. Any questions, please ask.